Hi everyone, my name is Akorede Adenike. You are highly welcome back to my channel. If you are new to my channel, consider subscribing and don't forget to turn on the notification bell for you to be notified each time I upload new video. If you are my old subscribers, I really appreciate you for coming back to my channel. Thank you so much. Today's tutorial shall be the making of fancy rose sleeve, which is going to be two parts. The basic sleeve part, which is the upper part, and the rose part, which is the down part of the sleeve. Now, these are the material I'm using for the tutorial today. I have satin fabric here, I have color stay, and this is my crinoline. Some people used to call it horsehair braid. In the absence of color stay, you can make use of hard paper stay. I'll first of all draft my sleeve before cutting it on the fabric. This is my basic sleeve pattern. I'm going to trace out my upper part from this basic sleeve now because I have long sleeve here. I have a video on how to draft it. I'm going to put the link in the box below. That is for that. This is the paper I'm using for the down part of my sleeve, which is the rose part, and I'm using full flare for it. So to get amount of paper folding for it, I'm going to deduct my upper part from the full length of my sleeve. The full length of my sleeve is 22 inches, while the upper part is 13 inches. If I deduct that 13 inches from the 22 inches, the remaining inches will be 9 inches. I'll put that one aside. To get the radius of my flare now, I'm going to find the circumference of my elbow, and the circumference of my elbow is 11 inches. I double that 11 inches, that will make it 22 inches, and I'm going to use 6.28, which is the formula to get full circle to divide it. It will give me 3.5. So I'm going to add that 3.5 to the 9 inches that I get earlier on. So all together will give me 12.5. So this is 12.5 folded into 4 now. So I'm going to measure out that 3.5, which is the radius from the tip of my paper here now, from the center here. I'm going to measure that 3.5 round. And connect it. So that's it for the 3.5, which is the radius of my full flare. So from there, I'm going to measure, you know, I said it's 9 inches. The length of my flare is 9 inches, so I have 9 inches here. I'm going to measure that 9 inches round now to form that full circle. I'm going to connect it. I'm done measuring that 9 inches and I've connected it, as you can see. So I'm going to add 1/2 inch seam allowance to the upper part here. That is the allowance that I'm going to use to join it to the upper part of my sleeve, which is the basic sleeve part. I'm going to connect it. So having done that, I've just cut it out now. Here is the full circle we are talking about now. So on one side of my flare, I'm going to measure 1/2 inch out, which is going to be my seam allowance later. So I'm going to connect it. I'll let it reflect on the other side of it. I'm going to connect it as well. So this will be the open part of my flare. I'm going to open this part now. I'm going to refold it now after opening the one side of it, and this is the seam allowance for this side. So I'm going to refold it just like this. I won't let it equal again. I'll just place it on this line now. So hope you can see what I'm doing. But this down part will not be the same again. As you can see, you know, it's a flare. To make it equal here, that is what I'm doing now. Folding into two. I'm going to fold it again into two, making into four. This is all I fold. As you can see, this is all I folded. So after folding into four equal parts without meeting here, the remaining one I folded it into four equal parts, as you can see. So I'm going to open it up and trace those line out with my marker to make it clear to you guys. So this is all I have, all the lines I have now. So you have to be careful, because it's a little bit tricky. So while cutting, you have to be careful. While measuring, you have to be careful to make your job accurate and neat. Tracing all these lines out now, I'm going to number them. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So we have 7 lines here now. So for me to form the rows I'm talking about, and this is my sewing allowance for the upper part, like I said earlier on. So to form the rows now, on this part now, on this side, I'm going to find the middle of that 9 inches, which is the length of my flare. The middle of it is 4.5, which is here. From this line now, you know, this upper one is for sewing allowance. I'm starting from the second line here. So I'm going to measure 2 inches downward, which is here now, as you can see. So here on the number one line, I'm going to come down by 2 inches as well, from the original line, not from the seam allowance line. 2 inches, which is here. From the number two line, I'm coming down by 1.5, which is here. From the number three line, I'm coming down by 1/2 inch from the original line. So I'll connect all together till I reach the fourth line. So watch me as I do that. I'm going to be careful, just like this. I'm using my free hand to do that. Hope you can see what I'm doing. So this is just it now. Now to my down part of it, you know, we are still forming the rows here. Now on my number one line, I'm going to come up from the down part here. I'm going to come up by 5 inches, which is here. So on my number two line, I'm coming up by 4.5 inches, which is here. And on my number three line, I'm coming up by 4 inches. I hope you can understand me, please. Please concentrate on this part. So on my number four line, I'm coming up by 3.5 inches. And on my number five line, I'm coming up by 1/2 inch, which is here. So I'll now connect it for you now to see how it will really look like. So I'm using my free hand for that. You can use your curved ruler if you have it. But if you are good at your free hand, you can make use of it. So, just be careful while connecting, please. So this is what I have now. You understand what I did here? So I'm going to shade out where I'm cutting out now. So here, you know, I've already have seam allowance for the upper part of it. So I'm going to shade where I'm cutting out now. So this is where I'm cutting out. And the down part, I'm cutting this place out. So I'm going to cut it out now for you to see. So make sure you cut it very well to make your job neat, please. Yeah, now cutting this place. As you can see, this is what I have for my fancy rose sleeve. So I'll go ahead and place it on my fabric and cut it out. I'm going to add 1/2 inch seam allowance on the down part of it. I've already added 1/2 inch on the upper part of it. So I'm cutting my basic sleeve too out. So I'm going to trace it out and cut it out on my fabric for you guys to see. So let me done cutting all that I needed for my sleeve. This is the down part of my sleeve, which is the rose part. This is the basic sleeve, which is the upper part of my sleeve. I added 1/2 inch seam allowance here, and I added 1 inch seam allowance, 1/2 inch seam allowance here too. So I'm going to remove the paper and use it to cut the lining. I'm cutting the same thing as the fabric for my lining. So I'm going to put this one aside. And this is part of my sleeve. I added 1/2 inch seam allowance to it at the edge here. I've already added 1/2 inch seam allowance to the upper part here. So I'm going to remove my paper now by removing the pin that I used to attach it to the fabric. I cut both fabric and collar stay together. So I'm removing the paper now. Put it aside, and I'm going to take one of the fabric with my collar stay. I'll go ahead to my ironing table and go meet to my fabric on the wrong side of the fabric. Gumming my collar stay to one part of it, as you can see. So this is the second one, and this is the right side of my flare now. This is the wrong side where the gums, I mean where the collar stay is. So I'm going to place this one on it now. Let the right side face each other. If I want to stitch it together, this is the process. I'll just place it on each other like this. I'm going to place it on each other. Let the right side face each other. And I'm going to turn it like this. So where my collar stay is, that is where I'm placing my crinoline line before stitching. So I'm stitching the three together. One that does not have collar stay will be at the bottom, while this one will be on top it, and the crinoline will be on top this one, just like this. And please just fold it like this before stitching, please. So I'll go ahead and use pin to hold it down all through before going to my machine, and I'm going to stitch from here to the upper part with 1/2 inch. I'm stitching the down part to all through with 1/2 inch with my crinoline. So after doing that, I'm going to take my basic sleeve, place my lining on it, which I've already cut. I'm going to place it on the right side of the sleeve like this, right side of the fabric, and I'm stitching both sides with 1/2 inch. So when I finish with all that, I'll come and show you what's next. This is my basic sleeve. I'm done stitching both sides with 1/2 inch. So I'm going to turn it to the right side and give it a good press. Here's it. I'm going to give it a good press and fold it into two like this and stitch my side seam. So as for this, I would like to explain again because of the beginners. So the one that does not have collar stay is underneath, while the one that has collar stay is in the middle, and the crinoline is on the top of both. So I stitch my crinoline on the tip. If you are a beginner, you can first of all measure your 1/2 inch round and place your crinoline on that 1/2 inch before stitching to make it easier for you. I folded it in to avoid it from losing hope both sides. So I'll go ahead now and notch the edge here round, the bottom here. I'm going to notch it round with 1/4 inch. If you have excess fabric there, you can trim it off. I'm going to notch it round with 1/2 inch and give it a good press. Turn it to the right side and give it a good press. When I finish, I forget, when you are stitching it together with the crinoline, make sure you are pulling it, not stretching it, please. Let me show you very well. Assuming you want to stitch it now, I'm doing this all because of the beginners. So fold it here like this at the tip here. So at the second tip, when you reach there, you have to fold it again to avoid it from loosening up. And when stitching, you have to be pulling it just like this. Don't be stretching it like this. As you can see, this is the difference between the two. This is stretching and this is pulling. So you have to be pulling it to make it form the rolls we are talking about. So I'm done ironing it. As you can see, it's very nice and beautiful. And this is my basic sleeve. I've stitched the side seam. So I'm going to notch the center of my sleeve here. So before turning to the right side. So this notch here indicates where I'm starting my down part. I'm trimming the excess lining out. So this is where I'm starting my down part now. So I'm going to start by placing it like this. As you can see, this is the right side. This is where the collar stay is. So I'm going to start by stitching it like this. Let me use paint to hold it down for you to see how it's going to look like before moving to my sewing machine. So I'm using paint to hold it down. Let the right side of it face the right side of the upper part. Holding it with pin. So when I reach where I start from, I'm going to stop just like this, as you can see. So when I finish stitching it, I'll come and show you how to fold the remaining one to form rows that we are talking about. Without stitching it, it's forming the rows we are talking about. So let me quickly go and stitch it round, stitching it as I explained. So this is it. As you can see, this is it. And I stop where I start from, as you can see. So the remaining one, I'll be pleating it to form a rose, just like this. I'm going to pleat it round and use my hand needle and thread to tack it down. So it's the tucking. I let it fall at the middle here. Hope you can see what I'm doing. It's a little bit tricky, but you have to do it to make it form what you are expecting. Make sure you add your own creativity to it. I'm done forming my rows. See how neat and beautiful it is. So for me, cover up the rough edge. You can use anything. You can use big button if it is your desired color. Big button like this that you can tack to cover it up. You can use stone bead if it is bigger than this that can cover this place up. But I'm using my cover button. Here is it, made of this fabric. So I will just use it to cover this place up. Can see, guys, after tacking my cover button to it, here is the finishing look of it. If you find my tutorial helpful, please give me a thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel to support my channel. If you have any question pertaining to cutting and sewing, you can leave a comment in this comment section below, or you can join my Facebook group Details to Sewing, created by Akoride Adenike. I'm on Twitter and Instagram at Akoride Adenike. Please show some love by liking and following my page on Facebook at Akoride Adenike Sewing Tutorial. Till I see you in my next video, guys. Stay safe, stay blessed. Bye-bye.